G'day. Today's video we're going to talk about the display settings on MC1. Here you can customise the views and the values so you can suit your everyday needs. Let's take a look. Alright, to get to the settings page from the main menu, we push settings and here we have all the options. We'll just run through them quickly to give you an overview. The themes and brightness, we can change between the different themes the run screen's displayed in. We can select a brightness level or an auto brightness, so the screen will change with the lighting conditions. If we scroll down to the height and slope indicators, these change the values across the top of the run screen. We can also add a graphical display of the tilt on the run screen. On the cross slope, we can show a tilt indicator on the tool edge. We can change the values of the slope to be the cross slope to the model comparison, or the actual cross slope value, the raw value. The digital and indicator bar is the value for the cross slope in the top right corner of the run screen. Next options are the run screen widgets, which can be added or removed as needed. So the options are there. There's four different options to choose from. Under miscellaneous, we have a few different things we can set up for the operator. So we can hide the navigation bar, which is the bottom toolbar along the run screen, so it'll minimize when it's not being used. Clipping of the model, so that if we have a large model or a large project and performance is starting to get affected because it's loading so much data, we can clip that data to make it more manageable. Auto hide machine parts, so as we change zoom levels, the machine will start to obstruct the model, and by having this selected, those machine parts will be made invisible. Machine image is a manual on or off, so we can have the view of the machine on the model or not, or on the run screen, as well as the machine tool. Now the tool points can be split, so you can adjust the tool point. Say if you wanted to adjust the left or the height tool point to the left of the bucket, you can choose to merge the side offset and the height tool references to move with the same setting. So it'll follow. So if you move your height to the left, the side will follow. Highlight the cutting edge puts a red line across the cutting edge so it can be easily displayed or easily identified on the run screen. And we also have another widget, but the bucket rotation value can be added to the run screen as well. We have another sorting of the models option here, so it can be proximity to the machine or alphabetically. The crosshair style, we can have no crosshair projected to the surface, we can have a T-style crosshair or a crossed crosshair. The T-style can be handy for if you have the bucket image or the machine and bucket image not visible, but you still want to see the direction of your bucket. The crosshair length, you can have a conventional size or you can extend it to go to the limits of the model. Next we have units and decimals. Here we can change the linear units between metric and some imperial measurements. We can change the number of decimal places that are viewed on the run screen. And we can also change the steps of which the things like the height offset or side offsets are adjusted in increments of 0.1 point, whatever you wanted to check. We have another setting for the DXF units. So they're all displayed or options to display on the run screen. Another option we have are the slope units. So we can have everything available that the operator may need. And again, we can change the decimal places for the slope units, individual of the other measurements on the screen. And we can have a dot or a comma as a separator for a decimal point. Next settings we have is time and language. We have multiple languages. We've even got English for Australians. But we have pretty much everything covered there for every region. The time and date can also be set. The last one we have on the list is connectivity. So if you wanted to connect to Wi-Fi or a SIM card setup, Ethernet and your Connex connectivity is there as well. And this is where we also connect to the VNC server option. And that's it for the settings menu. Thanks for watching.